All right. Well, I'd just like to give a shout out to Team Dynasty and Scottie Hobbs joining us tonight for this combined team call. Of course, got to give a shout out to Team Symbiotic as well. But we just think so highly of Scottie Hobbs and team. We're so friggin' excited. And for those of you who are joining us, we've put together what I think is going to be a great call. P90X3 is out. Who's got it? Type P90X3 into the chat. Or who's ordered it at least? Because I don't even have it. Mine hasn't arrived yet. I don't know if you've heard, but it's beating Beachbody's forecasts, and they're already setting records. Crazy. Craziness. It's awesome. Perfect time of year, isn't it? Get everybody re-engaged and focused on a new, you know, new plan. It's just perfect timing. We've got great leadership at Beachbody. All right, let's talk about tonight's call. So I'm going to do some quick introductions. We're going to talk about how to deal with missed expectations, because not everybody is happy with how the year ended. Okay, myself included. I know Scottie feels that way. We're going to talk about that. Okay, so you can stop beating yourself up. We're going to talk about the new year coming soon and the incredible opportunity we have for a fresh start and how people are going to be coming out of the woodwork interested in fitness. We're going to talk about why it's important to set new goals, your daily method of operation, setting realistic goals, and how to reverse engineer a goal. Now, I want to take a quick moment to recognize the fact that you guys are all here 6 days before Christmas. So Merry Christmas to everybody. But I'd like to recognize that you're here. That says a lot about you, that you care about helping others, you care about your business, and you're not going to get distracted by all the crazy consumption that's going on around you. So, yeah, Merry Christmas, Happy Kwanzaa. Happy holidays, all right? Okay, so let me jump into this. If you're brand new, you're a newer coach, welcome to Beachbody, and welcome to our call. You know, when Scottie and I got into Beachbody, we were just customers. We didn't get into this knowing that we were going to build a business or knowing that we were going to have crazy success. We just wanted to get in shape, okay? And Beachbody has changed our lives dramatically. It's changed our lives physically, helping us get into the best shape possible. And through that process, it changed our outlook on life, and it changed what we believed was possible and what we were able to accomplish. And it grew beyond just physical transformations. It grew into a lot more. As some of you are familiar, both Scottie and I have been able to quit our jobs, retire spouses, pay off a lot of debt, pay off, you know, all kinds of stuff, build six-figure incomes. But most importantly, what drove us to do that was to be home with our families. And now we're both stay-at-home dads that get to enjoy true financial freedom. You know, my buddy Jake, love my buddy Jake. He's in the chat. He's a funny guy. But the other day he asked, what defines success? And, you know, I told him, I said, being engaged in helping others, you know, but also being able to do what you want, when you want, with whom you want. That's success, and that's what's possible with Beachbody. But Scottie and I are very cognizant of the fact that we want more of you to experience this too. Our deepest desire is to see you succeed and experience the blessings that we have. You know, some people want to make this a full-time income. Some people just like being a part of the team, like, you know, helping others, like being healthy and fit and being engaged. Whatever your goal is with it, there's room for you within Beachbody. Okay. There is room for you. But our desire is to help see more of you succeed. It's not really about us at this point. It's about you. So I'm going to turn the time over to Scottie here in just a minute, but I just want to encourage you to stop beating yourself up. I don't like to focus on the negative, but I think we got to, you know, address the elephant in the room. How many of you are disappointed with how this year turned out? Maybe with your business or whatever. Go ahead. You can type it into the chat. You mean there's more than just one person? You mean it's more than just myself? You know, Scottie and I are not, we're not strangers to failure. It's funny, when we were preparing for this call, he's like, man, I've got a bunch of my diamonds who've dropped rank and it's just really bothering me. And I said, dude, I've got a bunch of my diamonds that have dropped rank. And as we started comparing notes, we were like, wow, we both got a lot of people that are struggling. And, you know, it's easy to think the grass looks greener on the other side. It's easy to think that everyone else has got it figured out. But we all have struggles and we all have disappointments. I mean, you think about it. Last year, Scottie and I both pushed each other to get into the top 10. I got it, went to Argentina. Scottie didn't. And that was really hard. This year, we're pushing for it again. Scottie is in the top 10. I'm not even in the top 25, right? And it, you know, I didn't start out the year wanting that, but halfway through the year, once I went to Summit, I was like, I want top 10. Didn't happen. Didn't happen. Now, you may be thinking, well, geez, I just like to accomplish something much smaller than that. Well, we're going to share with you how we got started and many more failures that we've had along the way. But please stop beating yourself up about losing rank. When I was a one-star diamond, I dropped to emerald. We both have a lot of diamonds who've lost rank. Here's the thing about rank. It's temporary. It doesn't define who you are. It doesn't define your success. It goes up. It goes down. I mean, seriously, you can be a 10-star diamond and one person doesn't order their Shakeology and you lose rank, okay? You lose to 9 or whatever. So you've got to keep that in perspective. That little rank in your office doesn't define who you are. It's great to achieve it and you will always be that lifetime rank, but please stop beating yourself up about losing a rank, because we've all, every single top coach I've talked to has lost rank. The only difference between them and others is they don't give up. They keep going. They regain that rank or whatever, you know, whatever it is, that goal that they have. One of the most common causes of failure is the habit of quitting when one is overtaken by temporary defeat. Let me read that again. One of the most common causes of failure is quitting, the habit of quitting, when one is overtaken by temporary defeat. Okay? It's not the failure that's the problem, it's the quitting. Now, I'd like to bring on my good friend Scottie Hobbs. Before I do, I'd like to tell you a little bit about Scottie Hobbs. This was him and I at my house in the Team Symbiotic gym. Scottie brought his awesomeness to my gym. And, you know, the thing about Scottie is, he is a real dude. He is not afraid to share where he came from and who he was and, you know, the mistakes he's made in his life before this. But what I love about Scottie is he's an eternal optimist. He lets go of the disappointment. He lets go of the failures, the negativity, and he just radiates positivity. He is a big advocate of personal development, as you know, and bettering yourself. But he's also a family guy, and that's what I love about him. He has his priorities straight. This isn't about money and material things for Scottie. This is about life and helping people and being there and making a difference. And that's the kind of guy that you've got with Scottie. And, you know, I've got to say something else that some of you may not want to hear, but this is speaking directly to the people on Scottie's team. Guess what? Scottie doesn't have to do anything for you, but he chooses to. If you're, if you've read GoPro or you've learned anything about network marketing, it is not your upline's responsibility to do anything for you. It is your opportunity to grasp and run with it. But guess what? Every day, Scottie is there. He's present. He's accounted for. He's inspiring. He's teaching. He's cranking out videos. He's doing team calls. I mean, he goes above and beyond what any leader or upline would ever be expected to. And he does that for you. So I really hope that you'll listen in, you'll sit up, you'll pay attention, because you won't ever, I mean, I don't think in your lifetime be placed under someone like Scottie Hobbs and have that opportunity right in front of you. So I hope you make the most of it. And with that, Scottie, I'd like to bring you on the line. You might have to unmute yourself again. And are you there, buddy? Let me see. Scottie.
Here we are. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Awesome.
Let me make you a presenter while you're going, and then you can advance your slides.
Okay. So thank you, David, for sharing that stuff. You know, just for David's team as well, because I know we are privileged to be on your team call tonight, and you're letting us hop on here and speak with you guys. It was awesome talking with you yesterday and deciding to do this together, and it was kind of cool connecting with you again. And about, you know, it was funny, we were talking about our failures more than any success that we've ever had, which is great, because in anything, you know, if you want to be able to succeed in anything, you have to fail a lot. So I just want to say that you guys also have a great guy in David. Like, I'm always so inspired by David for a couple reasons. You know, he went for top 10 like he shared last year, and he got it, aside from Wayne Wyatt, the only guy in the top 10, you know. So he's got a special something about him, you know, that he really cares about you guys and about your guys' success. You know, the same things he shared about me, he's, you know, he's there for you guys. And that's, you know, running a team call like this, I get messages from so many coaches across the company that don't have team calls to even plug into. So it's awesome that you guys have David here to share with you guys. And I love how honest he is with you guys, sharing, like, you know, his struggles, what he's going through, and some of the things, like he asked me that we could share. I was like, man, that's awesome. I think it's really neat that we get to be able to do that, because it's one thing that I know I've struggled with sharing. And I was talking with my coach Lindsay recently about this. Is a lot of times when things are going good, you share your successes, but it's like there's a success every 2 weeks or month, and there's hundreds of failures in between there, you know. So I'm gonna see if I can move this slide here. Let's see, there we go. So I was thinking about what I want to share. A lot of you guys have probably heard my story, but I'm gonna connect really with you guys just briefly on my story on the failure end of my life. I guess David shared that I've shared a lot of things that I've done wrong in my life, bad choices that I've made, which defined, in my mind, defined who I was as a person. But one thing I know about myself is I've always been, like, and it was taught by my grandpa and my dad, that you have to, the saying is, if you're going to do something, do it right the first time. You know, if you're going to do something, do it right the first time. So I take that attitude every single day in my life, you know, with my business. It's like, if I'm going to do this today, it's going to be a waste of my time if I don't do it right. So I've always had that kind of attitude growing up, and I, unlike many people I've met, I have really amazing parents. Religious, took us to church every week, you know, and taught us good principles, played with us as kids all the time, took us to the park and played baseball. My dad gave me countless hours, as I wanted to be a pro baseball player when I was little. You know, I got to play in the Little League World Series. And I'm a guy... This to share with you guys. I'm the kid, like, in junior high that had the big, big glasses that were always crooked, and I had headgear, you know. But I believed in myself. Like, if I wanted to be a baseball player, I knew I could play baseball because it depended on me practicing and me doing the things every day, you know, countless hours every day to become good at it. Like, what I look like or any of that stuff didn't determine who, you know, who I was as whatever part of my life or what I wanted to be. And so I always gave 100% to everything like that. And speaking of failures relating to baseball and then to another, a few other things is, like, I haven't shared this one very, very often, but I was pretty stoked. I knew I was going to play on the high school baseball team and play college and be a pro. Like, I knew it. It's like, I just knew it in my mind that I would be that. And I went to play baseball, and it was my junior year. I didn't try out my sophomore year, and I kicked butt. And here's the thing about me, like, they don't start tryouts and everything until the spring, but they had a group of people from the year before that were throwing baseball every morning, like an hour and a half before in the gym downstairs of our high school. I got up every morning and I threw baseball. You know, I pitched and threw with all the players throughout the whole winter, not just spring right before the tryouts and in the spring training. But I practiced every single day, and I kicked butt in the tryouts, you know, hitting balls like no other, fielding, pitching well. And it came to the time when they told us to, you know, they gathered us in the room. They put up the list of the names, and my name was on the list. I was like, heck yeah, I'm on the baseball team. Freaking pumped. I'm going for my dreams. And so I went down there for the first day, and they gave the big speech about the new year and everything and handed out jerseys, and I did not get a jersey. There was no jersey for me. Everybody gets on their jersey, and they head out, and I'm sitting there by myself in the gym in the basement of our high school, and I walked into the coach's office, and I was like, where's my jersey? And it turned out that they made a mistake. My name was printed on accident or something like that. He had some excuse. And so I felt like a failure, you know. And that was like my chance where I knew I could, you know, step out of my comfort zone and become a little bit more and be involved with other guys in the school and not be just the kid that goes to school and studies and goes home. So I was pretty bummed about that. This is just one of my failures. But my life was like full of failures like that. And because of those failures, I always did things that I thought would make me fit in, where I felt like I fit in, that made me – I'm a shy, quiet person. So, you know, I turned to drugs and alcohol at one point in my life because it made me talkative and it made me, I guess you could say, fun to be around, an outgoing person instead of the quiet, laid-back guy that I was. So those are all failures in my life. And you know – I think it's important to share those things because many people think that a successful person has always been very successful and everything, but that's so not true. You know, my life looks like you guys can see this screen here. My life looks like that squiggly line right there. Even still today, I struggle with different aspects of my life that I have to continue to fail, pick myself up, learn from it, and continue forward. So just understand that, you know, I've been a coach now for 32 months now, so almost 3 years. And, you know, we've become very successful, you know, financially, ending in the top 10 this year. But it does not by any means look like that arrow on the left-hand side. It looks very much so like that squiggly one on the right, if not way worse than that. Because every single day we fail like you could never imagine. David might share some of those things, but I deal with disappointment, you know, every single day. And that's what I want to come across with you guys. I want to be very genuine, very truthful with you guys on what it takes to become successful, what I consider success, what I consider how you can gauge success so that you know you're successful, whether or not the little things are going around you like David shared, whether someone drops a rank or this and that. And David shared with you guys that, you know, we're out here like, I don't have to do team calls. I don't have to make videos for everybody. I don't have to be on this call right now, but I want to. It's part of my passion. It's part of the reason why I love being a Beachbody coach and why I've become so successful with it, because I've been able to find what it is that I'm, you know, your why. You'll hear people talk about your why. You know, my why in the beginning was, you know, I got a result with it. I loved it. I loved sharing it. I felt great sharing it. And then I had the why to bring my wife home. And then I did that and my why got bigger and I wanted to bring myself home. And then we've been able to experience that now for a year and a half. So it's like, okay, so now, and then the next thing was pay off the house. That was a big goal and we were able to do that. So now my wife's home, I'm home. We have no debt we have a home paid for at the age of 32. So it's like, why, back to that why word, like why, so why do I give my Thursday night to you guys? Why do I want to be here sharing with you guys? And it truly, honestly, genuinely is, I'll be honest, I cry sometimes thinking about some of you guys and how much potential I know you guys have, just being like, dang, would you get on the team call and learn? Because we're here sharing with you guys. We're here teaching you guys. And I know you're struggling. And I know this can change your life. And I made a video the other day sharing about, like, I explained, and David will attest to this, like, if you could be in our shoes, like as a stay-at-home parent for 1 week, just, or 2 weeks, doing webinars, making YouTube videos, inviting people to your challenge group, doing what we do as Beachbody coaches, but with no other responsibility from anybody else job-wise, and no stress about bills, and you can have all the time you want for your family. If you could just feel that for one week, 2 weeks, I guarantee you would make so many sacrifices and you would be willing to fail a million times. And you'd be willing to fail a million times for the next 7 years even to get to experience what that feels like. So I want you guys to understand that it's there for you guys and you guys can do that. And it does take sacrifices and it does take struggling and going through that windy circle of what, you know, that picture before. It's not just a straight line to be there. And you're going to deal with a lot of disappointment. And just touching on disappointment for you guys right now, missed goals. Like I made a YouTube video saying, I'm going to be a 15 star in two business centers this year. I'm going to be top 10 and be a 15 star diamond in two business centers. I was 100% positive because the beginning of this year I was kicking butt, you know, hitting Success Club easily every single month. Just like, bam, bam, bam. I had coaches hitting Success Club, nailing it. Bam, you know, had like 15, 20 of my personal sponsor coaches hitting Success Club in the beginning of the year. And I'm like, oh, we're totally nailing this. I'm putting it out there, out to the universe so that I can create this energy and law of attraction. And we're going to make this happen. I don't know how, but I believe it. We're going to make it happen. Well, I ended out, I'm a 7-star diamond in my first business center currently right now. And I am a diamond coach in my second business center. So I want you guys to get that. I'm 8 diamonds currently short in my first business center of that goal. And I am 15 diamond coaches short of my goal for being a 15 star in my second business center. And I'll tell you, and I want to be honest with you guys, I have 7. So this year in my first business center, we created 9 diamond coaches. 9 diamond coaches, and 7 of them are currently not diamond coaches. And I know some of them are on here. We have some of my diamonds on here right now that were diamonds and are not diamonds right now. So I have 7 out of my 9 that are not diamonds right now. In my second business center, I had 2 diamonds, and I was super excited to start a 3rd business center when I got my 2 diamonds there. And I had 1 diamond for a little while, then I got my 2nd diamond. Waiting for it to be official with the 6-week wait period. One of the diamonds dropped, so I never hit 2-star officially. And then later, my other diamond dropped as well. And I'm just the diamond coach. So many would say, like, this doesn't work. I'm a failure. You know, what? You know, that's a lot of disappointment to set a goal that big and going on and seeing that type of failure happen. It's a struggle. So I know many of you guys, relating back to the beginning, you have a goal for a Success Club for your first time. You have a goal to be an Emerald Coach for your first time. And you push and you push and you push and you miss it. It's disappointing. You know, it's a struggle because if you honestly put in your effort, all the effort you could, and you did the 3 vital behaviors and the daily activity, it's disappointing because you're like, man, I did what I said I would do. You know, I set this goal, I did the activity, and it didn't happen. And David shared, like, you could lose you could lose a diamond because one person postpones their Shakeology for 2 weeks and they drop rank for a second, and that makes your diamond drop rank and you drop rank. So you can't let things like that determine if you're a successful person or not. And that's one of the biggest things that I'm going to have you guys take away from this business or from this call tonight is how to determine what success is for you, a little bit about setting goals, dreaming bigger, and then how to determine if you're successful or not. So I just want you guys to know, I deal with disappointment all the time. I mean, I was on the phone yesterday with Shiva on our team talking about some disappointments that I was having, that she's having. You know, she's like the top recruiter in the company, and she has struggles and disappointments. And I have disappointments and struggles. And I was talking to Lindsay Matway, my coach, the other week, and about the same thing that I talked with David yesterday. And she deals with the same things. You know, she has the same struggles and disappointments that we have as well. So I want to help you guys understand how to deal with the disappointment, how to deal with those things. And I'll tell you guys, I want to share a little bit about what my business looked like in the first half. And you guys heard some of it right there. Like, well, I was putting out goals, like double 15 star diamond, because that's how great it was going with everybody hitting success club. Like at the end of the year right now, I'll be honest, I said in the beginning, I had 15 to 20 coaches hitting success club. I have between 5 and 10 right now hitting success club. You know, so the first year was absolutely amazing. The first half was absolutely amazing. Right now is a little bit slow. And so that's a struggle. That's it could be a disappointment to me. And David pointed out something about me that he didn't tell me he was going to say that, but I'll tell you guys right now. One of the most important, like, you guys can watch my example of how passionate I can get and definitely consistent. I have not missed for 3 years, missed a day unless I was like, okay, I'm going on vacation, I'm going to be gone, I'll be back Monday. But I have not missed. Consistent, passionate. But here's one of the biggest things to help me overcome disappointment or struggles is definitely from the personal development aspect side of this. But I want you guys to know that, like, I focus on what I consider success on a daily basis. And I'm going to share that with you at the very end of this. But because I focus on that, the rest of it doesn't matter to me. Like, it affects me for like a millisecond. Like, there's been a time, I'll tell you guys, there was a time, you guys that are a little bit new in this won't quite understand this, but you can cap out on how much you make at a certain rank. So we were capping out at 7-star diamond in my first business center. In 1 week, we just dropped from 7-star to 4-star. And just so you guys understand, that's a $4,000 missed commission because of a dropped rank. $4,000 that week, that just, boom, we don't get it. But you know what? It didn't even affect me. Like, for 2 seconds, I'm like, oh, crap. But then I was like, who are these diamonds that dropped? What do we do to make them get back to where they're at? So, like, money is not an issue for me. Like, I am truly beyond blessed with what we've been able to achieve. So that means nothing to me. I get on these calls because I want you guys to feel and be where we are at in our business as well. You know, and whatever it is your goal, I want you to be there. My business in the first half is awesome in the beginning of the year because everybody has their goals and everybody's excited about their fitness and they're ready to rock and roll and get back in shape. And so it's going to be a lot better. And I'll give you guys an exact number. I didn't tell David I'm going to do this, so I hope it's okay. But I wrote down the numbers in 2012 the last week of December. This is – or so 2011, December 2011, the last week. We were making $700 a week with Team Beachbody in the last week of December 2011. By April, we were making $1,400 a week. So it doubled in the first 4 months of the year. And then fast forward to the next year, at the end of December, we were making $2,300 a week. And by April, we were at $7,000 a week with our Team Beachbody business. So that was a 200% growth the 1 year and then a 400% growth the next year. So the beginning of the year is the best time and you're going to see the most growth in your business as long as you're pushing hard on your daily activities right now. So I want you guys to understand that. For me, in the past 3 years, it's always been really good in the first – all my growth is in the first 4 months of the year. And then it, you know, goes into summit. It's still pretty good. And then at the end, it's just kind of – rides out and slowly grows and then a big growth again. So I want you guys to understand that that's how this business goes with that in that aspect. So, you know, we're coming on to the best part of the year. I want you guys to understand that. Man, David, sorry, I get excited. So I hope I'm not taking too much time, man.
Good, man.
So
good.
I want you guys right now, this is the time to dream big. Like, we talked about dreaming big last year with Summit, but I said those numbers because I want you to dream big, okay? I want you to dream big. And just so you guys understand, when I start, why I say I don't care about the money anymore, because I'm the guy that had to buy and sell stuff on Craigslist to sign up as a Beachbody coach. I had to find stuff, fix it, sell it on Craigslist to buy my Shakeology. I was like waiting, trying to earn that money to sign up. I didn't have internet. I did my coach training at my neighbor's house, and I did phone calls from my mom's house. And, you know, and then I was so excited to get my first smartphone, and then so excited to get internet in my own home so I could work from my house. So you have to understand that, you know, you guys need to dream big. Dream big. And I'm going to tell you guys, I'm dreaming big. I'm going to 15 star. I'm setting my goal. I'm going to 15 star by summer. I'm not going to let that not happen. And I want you guys to dream big as well. And what I want to talk about, dreaming big and setting goals, David's going to talk about goals, specifically how to set your goals. I'm going to tell you my aspect of what I feel about a goal. I'll tell you how I got top 10. I'm going to tell you guys the exact secret on how I got in the top 10 this year. This is what I did. Tell us the secret. Okay, the secret is I missed it last year, and like I wanted it, but I didn't believe it. So this year I said, okay, David got this. You know, my coach has done it twice now. I can do this. So I believed it. And from January 1st, I said, I'm going on the top 10 trip. I am going to earn it. And I wrote it on my board. I'm turning around right now. It's right there. Bold capital letters. It says, I will be in the top 5 in 2013. Number 2, top 10 trip to Rome will be awesome. Number 3, I can achieve anything I put my mind to. Number 4, I will always hit Success Club 10. So I say those things to myself every single day this year. And here's the thing about goals, guys. David's going to teach you how to reverse engineer it, but I'm going to teach you the big part of it. The most important thing is just to set the dang goal. Set the goal, because goals are like magnets. Okay? If you set the goal and you go to work from a list, like I'm going to teach you guys real quick, if you set the goal, you believe in it, and you go to work, and you do your personal development, and you grow as a person, goals are like magnets, and the people are going to be attracted into your life to help you achieve that goal. The people will be attracted in, or you're going to learn something in personal development, and you're going to speak the right thing to the right person at the right moment, or you're going to recommend the right book to the right person at the right moment that changes their life. So I want you guys to know that you have to dream big, and you have to set the goal big. If you don't set the goal big, you're never going to get there. So set the goal big from the beginning. And that's why it's so important, because like right now, just like David hit 15 star on top 10, I hit top 10, and you know, that was my big goal I hit, but I'm comfortable. Like, I'm very comfortable right now. And if you're comfortable, you're not growing. You're not growing. You have to be extremely uncomfortable every single day. So take every chance that you can to be uncomfortable. You guys have thousands of videos from coaches across the company and team trainings you can plug in and listen to. It's all great and stuff if you're listening to those every day, but it's going to do you no good if you don't act on it. If you don't take what you learn and act on it and just take the steps, you don't know how, have to know how to do it yet, but you have to do it. So you have to take the steps and make it happen. Okay. And you're going to fail a lot. You're going to fail every single day. I'm going to tell you guys, I've been on the phone in the past week and a half. Let me see my paper here. With 28 people that I walked through, just like I did in the National Wake Up Call, 28 people on how, you know, they're like way interested in joining my challenge group on January 6th. So I got them on the phone, found out their why, walked them through, set a date to order their challenge pack, everything. Yes, money. I'm going to do this. And okay, what day are we going to do this? Friday. Okay, can I follow up with you on Friday? Yes, follow up with me on Friday. 28 of those I have right now. I have 0 of those 28 that I've talked to in the past week and a half that have ordered a challenge pack. So a lot would think of that as frustration, a struggle, a missed goal, but it's not. I've done the steps, part of the steps that we're teaching you. It's a seed planted. Those people will be ready when they are ready, okay? So I need you guys to dream big. With dreaming big, it's all, you have to dream big first, but then a lot of you guys are here like, okay, what do I do now? You know, what's my next step? How am I going to take this? What am I supposed to do? Okay, I set this goal for Summit. I'm going to be a star diamond. Okay, now what do I do? What steps do I do? And Dave will talk about something real quick at the end, but we're going to come up with something for you guys that are dead serious about this business to help you guys become star diamonds. So we're going to help you guys, only those that are dead serious though. Like we're in the works on something, just so you know. But this is my list of things, okay, guys? This is what I want you guys to understand. Dave said that I'm like an optimistic person. I'll tell you what, like we've had some pretty crappy things happen in our life the past year. And you'll never hear us talk about it on Facebook. I don't let it affect me. Like, I mean, things from death of one of my best friends. Many, many things this year that could take somebody off course. But what we do is we focus on the positive. And what I want you guys to understand about your goals and about your daily activities that I'm going to teach you right here is, okay, get your notebook right now. I know you have your notebook. Get your notebook, put a, like 5 stars, and then write this phrase. You get what you focus on. You get what you focus on. So this is going to go with your goals, okay? If you focus on the fact that you can't recruit a coach, you're never going to recruit a coach. If you focus on the fact, like, I can't get Success Club 5, I'm going to tell you what, you're never going to get Success Club 5. If you say, I can't get anyone on my team to do anything. If that's the mental thing that you're telling yourself every day, you go to work. Let's say I give you this list of 10 things. You go to work and you're like, dang it, no one's listening anyway. I don't know why I'm doing this. No one's going to do anything. You're going to get what you're focusing on. And mentally, subconsciously, that's what you're focusing on. We hit top 10 this year because I subconsciously focused on getting that without, I didn't have a detailed plan or really a step-by-step how to get there at all. But that's what we focused on. So the daily activities attracted those things into our life that helped us get there. So remember that you get what you focus on. So you have to be in that mindset when you go through and do your list every single day. Remember, you get what you focus on. I'm saying it like 10 times. You get what you focus on. So here's my list of 10 things. I'm not going to read them all to you because I know Dave has something. David has some things that he needs to talk to you about. But every day. And when I say every day, I mean every day, except, you know, in the beginning, I did every day, 7 days a week, 2 hours a day when I was working full time. Now that I work this as a full time business, I just do 5 days a week, you know, a big gap of time, 6 hours, and I do my list of 10 things every day. So if you have an hour, you do your list of 10 things an hour. If you have 2 hours, you do your list of 10 things of that 10 things in 2 hours. So you guys need to print out your list. You can use mine if you want, but the thing is, make it somewhat similar. I mean, these are the activities that I do every day. So get your activities, print it out, have it like a checklist. So you have to mark it off every single day. And you have to be consistent and disciplined in this and treat it like a job. Like I've talked to some of my coaches, just so you guys know, we have 4 coaches that are personally sponsored coaches of ours that are making a 6-figure income with Team Beachbody. And I'll tell you what they do is they do this right here. They do the list of 10 things every day, just like a job. And as I've mentioned them, I've told them, look, it's like if you stop doing this, it's like a, like pretend it's like a job that you're going to get fired from if you don't show up. So you got to show up every single day. You got to show up because you got to show up for you to stay true to your word, to live a life of integrity. You say, I'm going to do 10 things. Then you do the 10 things, but not only for yourself, but for others. If you brought even one coach onto this business, or one customer, you better show up every single day for them, okay? Because they're counting on you to give them the example. They're not counting on you to do it for them because like David said, network marketing doesn't work like that. Nobody can do it for you. But you better, I say, you better show them how to do it. Like you better give them an example to follow. And that's what a leader does is give them an example. So this is the list of 10 things I do every single day. But the most important thing about doing this thing is you've got to do it every day. You got to be disciplined in that fact, and nobody can be disciplined but you yourself. So you got to be disciplined. But here's the other thing that we talked about briefly. You can't do it with the wrong mindset. You can't be like, oh, crap, I got to go do this Beachbody thing again today. Let me, you know, sit down for your hour and go through the list. And dude, I totally just kicked back in my chair all slouched and like put on a mean face that you guys couldn't see. Like you can't sit there and just like go through it just to go through it. You have to get in the right mindset, which comes through you doing your workout and doing your personal development. That's how I get in the right mindset to do my list. I do those things the very first so that I can have the right mindset to give my whole self to my customers, clients, and potential coaches and clients. So know that you got to do this list, but you got to get in the right mindset. And this is how you determine what success is. This is the last thing I have to share before I let David go. This is how you determine what success is, okay? Success isn't depending on your rank. I have very, very successful coaches on my team that are Emerald coaches, but they're very successful because they show up and they do what they're supposed to do and they find complete joy and excitement in that activity. So it's not dependent on your rank. It's not dependent on your income. Your income will be a direct reflection of the number of lives that you change. So this is how you determine success, okay? And it's up to you to do this, to be disciplined in it and go do this. First, write this down. You create your block of time that you work your business. You set that in your calendar. Number two, you do your list of 10 things and you do it with the right attitude, the right mindset and belief that you are going to make it happen. Okay? And you go and you do that. And this is how you're successful. If you do all 10 of those things and you did it with the right mindset, boom, you are successful. So you got to find joy in that. And that's where you find success. That's how I find success in my business is if I sit down and I get excited, I do my personal development, I do my workout, and then I give my heart to my list and I do all 10 of those things, then I was successful. I can go to sleep knowing that I am a success. No matter what rank I am, no matter who falls out or who cancels or who returns their order or who buys a challenge pack or not, I'm successful because I did what I said I was going to do with the right mindset. And here's I'm going to be very blunt with you guys on this aspect. If you say that you're going to do your 10 things every day and you do 8 of them and you're like, dang it, I'm tired, I'm going to bed, then you failed that day. I'm sorry, but you failed because you didn't do what you said you were going to do. And I believe to be very successful in this business, you have to be of integrity and be the very best that you can be every day. And to be the very best, you got to do what you say you are going to do. So David, I just want you guys, your team, my team's heard this a few times before, but that's what I want you guys to know is that like I have like 18 people that were supposed to buy challenge packs that didn't buy challenge packs yet. But that doesn't determine my success. My success is determined by my daily activity and knowing that I am doing the best that I absolutely can. And I give my whole heart and soul to it. And I do it with complete belief in my purpose and what I'm doing this for. And if you guys do that and you find joy, happiness, contentness, whatever you want to call it, in your daily activity, then you're going to be able to have a much more positive attitude moving forward. When you have a positive attitude, you're going to have a bigger impact on more people because people want to be around somebody that's positive, and your positive attitude radiates beyond what you can see. So remember to do that every single day, guys. And remember that it's so important to focus on that list and not get distracted so that you can do those 10 things and you can go to sleep and say, I was successful. And then just to end it out with my last little thing I want to share with you guys, if you go to bed at night, before you go to bed, take 10 minutes to give gratitude for your day that you were able to do what you said you were going to do. Gratitude for the people that are in your life. And then ask yourself a simple question. This is the question that I ask myself. If everybody on my team did what I did today, would my business grow and would it be successful? If I can answer yes to that, then I know I had a very successful day no matter what happened. So I want you guys to ask yourself that question every single night. And with that, David, I just want to let you know that I'm failing every single day. And it was actually really good for me to be able to share with you guys that I, you know, have those diamonds that are out and I struggle with those. Like I have those things, but that's how I keep myself focused on what success really is. And that's living my life of purpose and sharing and making an impact on people. And so thanks, David. I'm going to hand it back over to you for some more details.
All right, guys, we have a lot more to share. But first, I want to thank Scottie for amazing. You know, it's a beautiful thing when you hear Scottie Hobbs fired up. I was taking notes. I was paying attention. I was listening, pondering, thinking. And I hope that you guys were as well. Now, I'm going to call you out, guys. If you're on Facebook right now, shut it down. Seriously. I know how hard it is to focus on one thing in our day and time. It's like we all have ADD, but seriously, shut down Facebook, walk away from the TV, whatever's distracting you right now, focus. Okay. I promise it's going to be worth it. All right, let's jump into it. Who would like to hear about my amazing start as a coach? How to start amazing if you're a coach? Well, I'm sorry. I'm actually going to tell you about my amazingly slow start as a coach. This is the story that many of you don't know about because many of you weren't here. You weren't around. In fact, no one was around me when I started as a coach. This is going to surprise you, but you've seen my transformation, right? I showed a picture at the beginning of the call. You might think, wow, with a transformation like that, people must just line up to get help from David Ingram. People must line up to join his team, to join his challenge groups. Well, I'm going to show you something that's shocking. I took this screenshot from Facebook today, okay, because it's still there. You can find it by going into my Facebook. This picture right here. Take a close look at this. This is when I first posted my transformation on Facebook, December 30th, 2010. Take a close look at the dates in the top right corner. And then I want you to look at the number of likes that I got, okay? There are four. Four, okay? Four. And that one from Richard came like a couple years later. I got four comments from my good friend, myself, and my sister 4 hours later, and somebody the next day, okay? So I got two comments and three likes when I posted this photo of my transformation on Facebook. Why? I only had 140 friends when I started on Facebook. Yeah, who do you know that even has that few of people on their Facebook nowadays? It's hard to find them, right? Additionally, take a look at this. When I uploaded my transformation video to YouTube, I mean, it probably went viral, right? I even got it posted on the P90X Facebook page. Guess what? I got like 1,500 views, and then the views stopped after a week. So what did we do? My wife and I, we went into Gmail, and we sent an email to everyone in the address book. We were like, even that guy from church and that lady, you know, that and my teacher and everyone. We just hit the all button. We were like, send it, right? And not one, I'm not kidding you, not one of my guy friends joined. Not one. For 6 months. It took 6 months for any of my guy friends to actually join. So how did I start as a coach? I started with my wife as my first coach, my sister as my second coach, and guess what? I was paying for both of them. I was paying for both of their Shakeology. And where I grew from there were my other two sisters eventually joined, and then my wife's friends started joining. Okay? It took 4 months before I had a single guy join my team. His name was Tim Mills. He found me over the internet, and he called me, or he emailed me and said, I got to ask you a question about a fat caliper. Can we have a phone call? And I was like, ugh, I cringed. I was like, I don't want to get on the phone. Okay. And I got on the phone, and he asked me after about a 20-minute conversation, I was just helping him out, giving him free information and value. He goes, so how does this whole Shakeology thing work? And how does this coaching thing work? I think I want to do it. And I'm like, and that was my first real coach from somebody that, you know, found me on the internet and became my first. So yeah, that's how I started as a coach. All right. Now, why is David Ingram still here today? Because I didn't quit when I had all those setbacks. Okay. I knew at that point that I had an awesome story. I knew that I felt amazing inside, and I made it my goal. My mission was to share it with as many people as possible every freaking day. When I went to work, when I went to school in the evenings, when I went to church, you know, through YouTube, posting it on forums, like wherever I could, that was my goal. It was like, I know I've got something amazing. I feel better than I ever have in my whole life. And I'm just going to share it and get it in front of people who care, because the people around me at the time didn't care. Right? So here's what I do. This is what I did then, and this is what I do now when I'm facing adversity. And I've been doing this over the last couple months. When I realized I wasn't going to hit the top 10, I realized that other coaches had more momentum. They were bringing in more, they were just straight out recruiting me. I realized, okay, I've got to go back to the drawing board. I focus on improving myself, fitness, nutrition, and personal development. And then I work really hard to help other people get results and stay on track with their fitness and nutrition. Because what I found, this is how I built my business, okay? I find that if people are losing weight and feeling good, they're naturally gonna have more confidence, which is a great thing to have when you're inviting, but they're also gonna be attracting people to them who are just kind of going, hey, what are you doing? I'm noticing you're changing, right? So it really goes hand in hand. So whenever I feel like a failure in terms of inviting, I always go back to number one, and then I go to number two. Because when I'm working with people and just helping them, the relationships are built and new coach prospects arise. At this point, in my challenge groups, half the people will ask me about becoming a coach before I ever mention it to them. Brian, who's on the call, he's one of my brand new coaches. I'll ask you, Brian, who brought up coaching first? Did I ask you or did you ask me? Right. This is Brian's first team call, by the way. Let's congratulate Brian for being here. He's like, halfway through T25. He said today that he feels like T25, being in the challenge group and becoming a Beachbody coach is one of the highlights of his life. So that's the power that we have. And I never mentioned it to him. I just focused on helping him with his nutrition and fitness. So 2014 is a fresh start. And by the way, we're going to go over on time. I'm sorry. We can't always fit this into a little box. So if you have to leave at 7:30, I understand. It's cool. We're recording this. But if you want to stick around, I'm sticking around. Okay. So 2014 is a fresh start. Who would like a fresh start? If you're alive, you've got a pulse, you're listening, type it in the chat. Type me. All right. Because I'd like a fresh start too. Right? Now, what can you accomplish in 1 year? Let's just go back, okay? In my first year as a coach, I went from brand new to one star. Okay? So if you're not even like an emerald, this is what I did in 1 year. I became a one-star diamond coach, okay? Year number two, I went from one star to six star and a six-figure income. That's awesome. Again, a year. Year number three, I went from six star to 17 star and tripled my income. Now, here's the crazy thing about that, guys. That was this year. I started this year at six, and I had 18 diamonds by April 24th. I remember that date so clearly because that was the cutoff for Summit. And I had just got off of the Success Club trip at Disney World and told everybody I was gonna be a 15 star. So dang it, I better do it. And yes, from January, starting as a six star to April 24th, 17. 12 people advanced to diamond on my team. After Summit ended, guess how many people advanced to diamond? Only two after Summit, okay? Look at the first half of the year, look at the second half of the year. You have to know the industry that you're a part of. You're in health and fitness, and it goes in waves. If you don't believe me, on January, the first week of January, go to any local gym, and you're gonna see how packed full it is. A month later, 6 weeks later, go back and you'll see how dead it is, okay? Because New Year's resolutions. But you have to know that this business grows in waves. And what's going on right now, December, actually from about September to December, is we're gonna find out who's serious. We're gonna find out who's committed, who's gonna stick with us. We're gonna find out who got into this for the right reasons and who really is committed to their own health and fitness because they care about their health long-term, and those who care about helping others. That's what you're finding, okay? You're gonna lose people right now. I get coach cancellations every week right now. And it's sad. I look at every single one and I go, I guess this is goodbye. Like, I thought we were buds, and I guess this is goodbye. That's how it happens right now. But you will find that there will be a lot of people who you thought were lost and gone who will come back alive. Okay. So let's talk about setting realistic goals. Because that's what's most important, is you set a goal and it's got to be realistic. Now, you've probably heard this before. A goal must be measurable. It must have a deadline. And you should set smaller goals, accomplish them, and then set bigger goals. Okay. That is true. But I'm going to take it one step further. Okay. One step further about setting goals when it comes to Beachbody and being a coach. You have to set goals for the activity that produces the results. Here's the problem. We say, I want to be a 5-star. We say, I want to be a diamond. That's a great goal, but we don't back it up with the plan. And if you want to call them mini goals, you've got to set a goal to how many people are you going to get into a challenge group? How many people are you going to talk to? That's where your goal should be, because those activities are going to produce results that lead to that. Too many of us get caught up on just, I want to be a diamond. I want to be a 5-star by Summit. Well, what is the activity that you're going to do to get there? That's where your goal should be focused, because it's depressing when you only focus on results and you're not getting any. That's what brings you down. So always focus on the behavior, the activity that produces results. Now, I'm going to share some things on this call that you may probably haven't seen anywhere. And I know Beachbody would probably not want me to share it, or maybe even be embarrassed by it. But this is the truth. Okay. This is the truth about numbers that you have to know, so you can stop beating yourself up and stop thinking you're a failure. But I'm going to share it. So real quick, let's reverse engineer getting to Star Diamond. You can pick whatever you want. And you know what? I'll tell my story of how I got into the top 10. I decided that I wanted to be a 15. I did want to get into the top 10. I wanted to get into the top 10. And let me back up. I knew to get into the top 10, one of the key way you get elite points is volume coming from new coaches in that same year. So this was 2012. It was like January. I'm looking at the rankings that just came out. I'm not even in the top 25. Okay, February, not in there. March, not in there. I then went and looked up the top producers, and I saw they were bringing in like 10, 15 coaches a month. And that's when I set my goal of, I had to bring in at least 10 to 15 coaches a month. Okay, now you might think that's crazy. Well, guess what I did then is I backed up and said, how many people am I going to need to get into my challenge groups to get 10 or 15 coaches a month? And it was about 30 people a month that I had to get into my challenge groups just to get 10 or 15 new coaches a month. And I had to step up my inviting. I had to be more bold and ask them to become a coach and take the time to explain the benefits. When I started doing that and really focusing on inviting into my challenge groups, helping them get results, and then 30, 60 days later, inviting them to become a coach, I started bringing in 10, 15 coaches a month. Boom, my elite points went up. Boom, I started rising on the ranks of the leaderboard. There I am. I came in at like 22nd, and then 19th, and then like 17th, and then 15th, and then 12th. Boom, all the way where I landed at 8th in December of that year, because I was generating massive momentum. And I reverse engineered that goal. So it's okay to set a big goal, but then reverse engineer it and ask yourself, can I put in the effort that's required to hit that? If you can't right now, that's totally fine. Set a more realistic goal. Okay. Is that making sense? Okay, I'm going to break it down even further. So if you're like, I'm not even going for top 10. I just want to go for diamond right now. Don't worry, I'm going to help you out, okay? Or like, I would just like to get one person in my challenge group. Okay, we're going to talk about that. Okay, so let's talk about star diamond. You say, I want to be a 5-star diamond. well, what do you need to be a 5-star diamond or a 10? You need diamonds, right? Before you can be a star diamond, you need diamonds. And for me, before you have diamonds, they have to become a coach. And for me, before they become a coach, they are a participant in my challenge groups. Okay, I've tried it both ways. I've tried just bringing people straight on as coaches. I've tried just, you know, pushing the business opportunity. It doesn't work as well as really just focusing on being the best I can myself and then helping people get results with their fitness and nutrition. Okay, I've ridden the roller coaster. I rode it this year, okay? And this is what works, is it's about, it starts in challenge groups. Now, let's put some numbers to this to kind of bring it to a different level. So it's so, so important that you lead yourself first, right? Before you can lead others, you got to lead yourself. And what does that mean? Like, if you're not working out, you're not eating healthy, you're not doing personal development and growing, then how can you expect to lead others and for them to want to follow you and to, you know, listen to what you have to say, right? I didn't say you have to look like a fitness model. That certainly helps, right? That's nice. But you have to play the part of someone who is healthy, who's making good choices. I'm going to put one of my coaches on the spot. Chuck, he told me today, he goes, you know what? I let my nutrition get out of hand. And I thought I was bulking up for Body Beast. And next thing I know, I'm just, you know, eating like crap. And he said, I finally got back on the wagon this week with P90X3, really strict eating. And I told everybody at work, don't ask me what I want when you order takeout because I'm not eating it anymore. And he had coworkers say, yeah, I noticed how you've been eating the last couple months. And it's good to see the old Chuck is back. Right? You think people don't notice that? You think they don't notice when you go to that potluck and you eat all the desserts and then you're like, hey, you should join this Beachbody thing with me. I can get you a good deal on the challenge pack. You know, you gotta set the example. You gotta be true to the lifestyle that you're promoting, because people can sense if you're not really living it. They can see it. Now, I'm not saying that you're just the perfect robot and you never indulge or have fun, because sometimes you need to do that if people see you as like never, you know, enjoying yourself, or, you know, they see you as weird or they can't relate to you. You know, I'm like, hey, dude, I have a cheat meal every week, a reward meal. You know, so you got to balance it out. But if you're not playing the part of a fitness person, you know, a leader in health and fitness, then you know, you're going to be more challenged in building your business. So the most common mistake that failed coaches make is they don't talk to enough people. This is the part you'll never see in Beachbody training. Okay. But this is the most common mistake, is they don't talk to enough people. And the second common mistake, or another one they make, is they aren't consistent in their efforts to invite. Let me ask you a question, and I think this will be an aha moment for you. This is when the light bulb's going to go off, because this is what you can relate to. What kind of results would you expect from your workout if you did it one day a week? What kind of results can you expect if you eat healthy once a week? You might get some results. You might be slowly changing over time. But it's so much better to do the workout 6 days a week and crush your nutrition, because you get results and it builds momentum and excitement, right? If you're a P90X graduate on this call and you crushed it in 90 days, or Turbo Fire or Insanity or Asylum or Combat, you know what I'm talking about, right? It's exciting to see those changes. Well, inviting is the same way. Why would you expect great results if you're only inviting once a week, or you're not inviting on a regular basis? You're going to be that slowly transforming person who works out once a week, right? So when you invite on a regular basis and you're fast and furious, with your inviting, just like you are with your P90X and your other programs, it gets results. And the results are noticeable, and it builds excitement, and it builds momentum. If you do it the slow way, I think you know what it, you know what it looks like. So here's one of the worst assumptions that coaches make when it comes to inviting. Because we all have big hearts, we have some of the best people in the world in the Beachbody Network. We want to help everyone. And we believe that everyone should be on Shakeology and everybody can benefit. And here's where we make a bad assumption, is we believe that everyone will accept my help and will join my team. Because I want to help everyone. And so they should. My friends, my family, everybody. You know, if you look at this on the left, in blue are the people you're connected to. In yellow are the people that you invite. And green are the ones that actually join you. I'm going to break this down for you. This is what it really looks like in blue. You're connected to a ton of people, but you're only inviting a portion of them, small portion of them. And the people that actually join you is much smaller than that. Okay, let's put some numbers to this. If you're connected to 30 people and you invite 10, you might expect one to join. Okay, that's a pretty good number. In school, you're a failure if you get 1 out of 10. You've been conditioned your whole life to fail. You're a failure if you don't get 90% or better. Okay, so when you start failing in Beachbody, you quit. That's the natural tendency, is whatever I'm doing is not working. Whatever I'm doing is not working. I mean, you heard Scottie's numbers earlier about his challenge packs, right? He's like 26 people that he was on the phone with. That's impressive. On the phone, knows their why. 26 people, and only, you know, a handful of them have ordered. So it, you know, if you're getting 10% or 20% or 30, you're a rock star. Welcome to the club. That's an A+. Okay. Yeah, it's an A+. You're a rock star. You're at the top 2% of the class. You should sit in the front of the room. You're on the principal's honor roll. Okay. Now, if you want more than one person to join you, I just updated the numbers on the screen. Here's how you back into a goal. You're like, you know what? I want 5 people to join my challenge group. You might have to invite 50 to get there, right? And this is a funnel, like Jake said. This is a funnel that you've got to fill. You've got to keep your pipeline, your funnel filled. And you do that by always connecting to people, to new people, always talking to new people and inviting them. And that's when you'll have people join you, right? That's how you start getting interest. You know, it's kind of like you generate this buzz on your social media. You then start filling up your challenge groups, and then you're naturally going to see your number of new coaches go up from there. And this funnel continues. One of the most common mistakes that diamond coaches make, they sign up 10, you know, 8, I guess 8 and 2 emeralds. And they're like, okay, I got 12 people. They should all be doing what I'm doing. You might have one strong leader out of those 12, if you're lucky, right? So it's so important as a diamond or above to continue recruiting, continue connecting with people, inviting, helping, because that's the truth. That's just how it works. So I'm going to wrap this up. I believe this is my last slide before I give you a couple action steps. Just have the right expectations. No one is good at this in the beginning, but only you can create success. It's not your upline, not anyone else but you. And it takes learning, personal development, but putting that into practice, taking action. That's how you get there. And I promise you, the more you do it, the easier it becomes. So if you're new or old, whatever, commit to doing it long term. It makes a huge difference. Here's a couple action steps for you. Christmas is coming soon. I hope that you'll take this time to recognize how much your life has improved this year and express gratitude because of that. I know a lot of us feel disappointed in how we ended the year, right? But we've got to recognize how much our life has improved and changed. And just knowing each other is amazing. Knowing every single person, you know, just being associated with you guys on this call is a huge blessing. Like Scottie said, dream big for 2014. Set a big goal. Okay? Nothing happens with super small goals. Set the big one first, then break it down into smaller steps. Okay? Reverse engineer it. Then determine if you can commit to that level of effort. It's totally fine if you started with 5-star, and then when you reverse engineered it, you're like, I don't know if I could, you know, talk to that many people and invite. Okay. Bring it down a notch to what you can accomplish. Because once you start knocking down these goals, you're going to get momentum and you're going to grow as a person. Your capacity is going to grow. Your ability to knock down bigger goals is going to grow. And then 5, get to work. Be consistent with your daily to-do list. Scottie provided it. You can go to scottiehobbs.com or just Google Scottie Hobbs top 10 list or top, I think it's 10 to do, something like that. You can find it. Okay. Guys, we are done for tonight. This is a picture right there of the cruise, which we're going to be on the cruise in March. I hope to see as many of you there as possible. Thank you to Scottie and team. Thank you to Team Dynasty and to anybody else who joined in who's not on either team. It's good having you here. Let's make 2014 amazing. All right? Who's with me? Let's do it. Yeah.